love you more dearly, follow you more dearly, day by day. Amen.
Please be seated.
Namaste, my sisters and my brothers. Namaste. For those of you who are unfamiliar with the term, that is a traditional Hindu greeting. And so now, because some of you are wondering, maybe it was Stephen Balky who was leaving St. Paul's, we didn't think he was leaving Christianity altogether. I assure you, I am still a Christian. I think that actually part of what is really important in our Christian vocation as disciples is to study some things from other faith traditions, not just because it helps us to understand our sisters and brothers better, but because it actually helps us to understand our own faith better. Namaste is a wonderful example of that. What it actually means in its essence is when a Hindu person goes and greets someone else for the first time, sees them in the beginning of your day, saying that, actually saying, I see God in you. The God that's in me recognizes the God that's in you. I actually think that is something that gets at the very core of our gospel lesson for today. In this gospel lesson where Jesus' disciples are probably a little distraught and a little confused because they just got Jesus back. They just got him back. He had died and he was gone and they lost him. And then he rose again from the dead and they had him back. And now he's telling him, I'm leaving you again. But he assures them, I'm not leaving you alone because I am sending the Holy Spirit to you. Not just to be with you, but to dwell within you. That the Holy Spirit will abide in them. And he even tells them, it will be God in you. As the Father is in the Son and the Son is in the Father, God will be in them. That's important. This is at that principle, namaste, when they will look at their brothers and sisters and say, I see God in you because God is within you. Jesus didn't draw his disciples together to just keep them as disciples, right? He drew his disciples in to form them as apostles to then send them out into the world. He's equipping them to do that because Jesus' plan from the very beginning was never to come and teach them how to love God and love their neighbor by doing it for them. Right? He tells them, if you love me, you will keep my commands. They will be the ones who will be in charge of going out and loving God and loving their neighbor. And Jesus is going to get out of the way and let them do it themselves. And he's going to empower them to do it by literally placing God within them. So that when you go and do the work of loving your neighbor, you are loving God. And if you want to love your God, you must go and love your neighbor because God is in them. So the disciples go out. The disciples go out into the world looking at their brothers and sisters, being able to say, God is in me and I see God in you. And it makes me wonder that for us, what could we learn from this principle, this discipline of namaste? What would it be like in our own lives if every time we greeted someone, the first time we saw them, whether it's the first time you see someone in the morning or the first time you've ever met them, what would it be like for us if our first thought was, I see God in you. The God that's in me sees the God that's in you. It sounds like a little thing, but that would change. I have to believe that would change the way we would live in our relationships with each other. It doesn't mean we would always agree. It doesn't mean we wouldn't have fights with each other. There wouldn't be hard feelings and miscommunications. But our starting point is God is in you. And whether that is your boss that you're seeing for the first time, or your co-workers, or that kid who was really mean to you in school last week, or whether it's turning to your spouse in the morning and seeing her for the first time, and the first thought being, when I see God in you. How that would change things for us. How that would change the way you live in that relationship. Now, I think it's important to realize that, namaste isn't just a greeting. It's not just a salutation, it's also a validation. It's also how you say goodbye. And I imagine, again, what would it be like in our relationships if at the end of our relationship, whether it is at the end of the day or whether it's the last time we're going to see someone, what that would be like for us if we did what Jesus talks about doing so often throughout the whole gospel, the last thing we thought, I see God in me. The God that's in me sees the God that's in me. If we closed our relationships, we closed the day, whether that relationship was positive or negative, whether it was joyful or hard, whether there was hurt feelings, if at the end of that relationship we look at the other person and see God in them. Part of the reason why that's a discipline to actually say the word is because it's easy to see God in our neighbor when the relationship has gone well, and we like that person. But it's important that we strive, as Jesus has taught us, we strive even when we're tired, even when we're stressed, you know, even when we've been hurt. What if we ingrained that as part of who we are as God's people? If we made it our business to be about greeting people and saying goodbye, seeing God. I am very blessed to have been here for the last couple of years. From the day I arrived at St. Paul's, to be able to look out and see a people filled with God. A great joy to be able to say, the God that's in me sees the God that's in you. And for the last couple of years, as we've had triumphs and trials, moments that have been filled with great joy and moments of hardship, in the fellowship, and in the formation and in the ways we have served, it has been a great blessing to be able to see God working in amongst the people of St. Paul's. To see the relationships grow as God is in you. And you look and you see your neighbors and you see God in you. And now that I'm on the other side and it's my turn to say goodbye to you all, it is with great pride that I can say, the God that's in me sees the God that's in you. Namaste, my sisters and brothers. Namaste.